Apple. But no, not that Apple, this Apple. You know the one I'm talking about. Who on this planet doesn't know the one I'm talking about? iPhones, Macs, Apple TVs, HomePods. I literally have all of them. I like Apple stuff. Call me a fanboy or whatever, but the whole Apple ecosystem, when put together in one place, makes an absolutely delightful experience. The experience is what Apple's crafted for their users. They make a whole world of everything working together. I think the word they use is ecosystem. But it's more than just what they make for their customers. This video isn't about how Apple makes cool stuff. This video is about apps and Apple's ability to sell the dream. Apple made programming and tech sexy. People who make apps. Oh, and by the way, the word app is part of the sexiness. Nerds make applications. Sexy programmers, app developers, make apps. Making an app is easy, according to Apple. But not just easy, it's a lifestyle. You have an idea, you have a passion, want to solve a problem for the world? Just make an app for that. So, I made an app. But what I learned along the way is that making an app isn't as simple as Apple has led us all to believe. Oh, and here's another thing this video isn't about. This is not a video about coding. It's not about how to learn Swift or use Xcode. This video is about everything else. It's the everything else that will destroy you. It's the everything else that will take your beautiful, passionate idea and squash it into oblivion. It's about all the stuff that Apple doesn't tell you. Doesn't tell you while they're on stage at the Worldwide Developer Conference, selling the dream of being a sexy app developer. Day one, your dream is alive. You have an idea, you think, I'm gonna make an app for that. And maybe you also think, hey, maybe I can sell this app, make a little money on the side. So you get to work. Day one might be a day, or a month, or a year of coding, but it doesn't matter because you love it. You're turning your beautiful idea into a reality. You're motivated by seeing your thing come to life. It doesn't really matter how long day one is because it's what you love. By the time day one is over, you feel a relief and satisfaction. You made an app. And day one might be your last day. Making an app for yourself can end right here. You can use it. But for other people, people who want more, people who want to share their app with the world, you need to push forward to day two. Day two. You already knew this stuff. Jumping from making something for yourself to making something for others always requires additional effort. You know this already. Your app needs a name, it needs an icon, it needs a description, it needs all these things that you can just call metadata. The stuff about your stuff. But it's more than that. Because if you want to make an app with Apple, you need to put it on the App Store. To put it on the App Store, you need to be an official Apple developer. To be an Apple developer and to put things on the App Store, you need to buy the right to do so. So fork over the money, the $99 for the right, the privilege of making an app and sharing with the world. Then wait for your approval. So you thought you were on day two, but day two doesn't even start until Apple deems you worthy of their ecosystem. After several days of not day two, you get the approval. You go in, fill in all the metadata. This could be the day your app goes public. Day two has been hard and the payoff is worth it until you realize that day two is just the beginning. Day two informs you of what lies ahead. Day three, you thought you were at the end, but you learned you weren't. Making stuff is always a process of learning and getting to the end is part of the journey. So this is what you learned. One, if you want to offer subscriptions, you need a subscription server. Two, you need a privacy policy. Three, you need app terms. Four, you need a contact form. Five, you need a website. Six, you need not just one icon, but a set of icons in a bunch of different resolutions. And seven, if you want anyone to even care about your app, you need a demo video, or at least some nice images. By the end of day three, you've probably come to the conclusion that to sell an app, you don't need passion and drive. You need a business and a website, and maybe even a lawyer. Apple doesn't tell you any of this. It's a bit of disillusionment. Day four, your dedication and desire to finish is what you need to lean on. Day four is not a day. It might be a month, but maybe this video can help you shorten that time, and maybe you won't need a lawyer. The subscription server. Use revenuecat.com. This is not a promotion. You can get a starter account for free, and it will remain that way until you hit the very reasonable revenue threshold. Adding subscription support and enforcement means going back to day one again, if you didn't already think about how you'd build paywalls in your app. But RevenueCat has all the docs you need and video tutorials on how to get it started. Here's a few things to look out for. Read the docs first, from the beginning. Name your subscriptions correctly. Set up your packages correctly. Try not to have to do it twice. It's painful. More paperwork. To sell your sexy app, you need to do unsexy things, like sign agreements with Apple and provide banking information. Learn to be patient. Paperwork takes time for approval, and Apple sandboxes are not great. After setting up your subscription details, you must get your app to the ready for review stage before any of your subscription data is available in the sandbox environment. Also, don't bash your head on the desk if it doesn't show up. Caching and propagation are a real thing. Restart your computer, clear your caches to make sure you're getting a fresh connection. Marketing website and support website. Remember, your goal was to build a sexy Apple app, not a website. A simple one-page site will do the trick. Some images, a description, some FAQs, and most importantly, a contact form. If you're a web developer, you can whip something up and host it for free on netlify.com. Again, not a promotion. It's fast and it's free. If you want an easier but less free way to do it, go make a site on Wix. Privacy policy. Legal stuff will suck your soul out of your body. Avoid this at all costs, but cover your ass and meet the requirements. Use termly.io, again, not a promotion. This site will ask you some questions about your app and generate a full privacy policy for free. They will try to upsell and email you, but you can get what you need and export it to HTML and put it up as a second page on your website to meet the App Store requirements. Terms of use. Just use the Apple stock EULA. Put a link to it at the bottom of your app description in the App Store Connect admin interface. This will appease the app reviewers. Icons of all shapes, sizes, and formats. Use Figma.com. Again, not a promotion. Go create a free account and you can make pretty much anything you want there on the massive canvas. You can group things together and export as PNG, JPEG, or SVG. All right, end of day four. All the hurdles have been jumped and you're in the final stretch. You can feel your excitement coming back as you finally complete all the fields and check all the boxes. But as you look down the final stretch, you see one last obstacle in your path. Day five, the final stretch. It's finally time to hit the button. It's the button that Apple is famous for in the dev world. App review. Passing app review can be incredibly easy or severely painful. So follow these steps to pass App Store review on the very first try. One, make a demo video. If your app can't 100% be used by the app reviewer, you'll need to make a demo. It doesn't need to be fancy. Just talk through the features while recording your screen. Just do the demo. It'll help you get past the review. Two, cross your T's and dot your I's. Make sure the EULA link is in the description. Make sure your URLs are correct for the marketing website and the support website. Add links to the terms and the EULA in the app itself. It's required. Three, check your entitlements. When your app needs extra capabilities like network access or Bluetooth access or health data access, you need to request entitlements. Make sure to explain your use of each of the entitlements and why your app needs them. Okay, now hit submit and wait. Day six, this is the day. Wake up in the morning, check your email. Many emails from Apple, and the process unfolds. And then, the one you're waiting for. Approval. Hit the button and feel the excitement again. Forget all the pain. You're now a sexy app developer and your passion has been shared with the world. Now, just figure out how to spread the word about your magnificent app. Day six, by the way, is just day one of your app marketing journey.